Happy to hold the wave. He just keep left CD and Candy back lane, always threatening with a hook here. And again, whenever Candy comes in, just eats a buckshot.
And yeah, now he has to back away.
Oh, that hook was amazing. Flies back in as well. First blood goes to Woosh.
That is
kind of see why. King off to a good early start here. Condi though has found Assassin here with Dade now as well. Ari will spear rush out of the way. The death mark might be enough. No, it's not quite. The ignite is ticking down, but Assassin should be okay. Lives on barely any health, and MLXG sneaks away the dragon.
Yeah, remove the option of split pushing for Dade. I feel like M3's team comp just doesn't have the options in the mid game. But speaking of options, that's an aggressive option from Dade.
MLXG coming in, but he gets knocked up immediately out of it. And MLXG just cleans out the next kill. Looper cancels his teleport though, and you can see why here is Sky actually going to get aggressed on by Condi and Looper. Hecarim does finally fall there just with the constituent parts of the Trinity Force. But down the bottom, Woosh going to get Love City. Dade's down here as well. The land actually lands a hook there. The exhaust is there as well. The Flay's moved in, and Woosh might even get another kill here as Assassin dives in to clean it up. Corki does get the trade, but that's a double kill for Graves.
Yes.
The leader's on. It continues to climb as well. Dragon back in 40 seconds. Tier 2 turret going to fall here as well. MLXG happily face tanking that one. Although, no, not quite low enough. Love City is into defender. Condi does get the next kill. Rides on top of the Rek'Sai and the bear stuns them up. King can't answer.
Yeah, the spirit spell vamp that he's going to get. M3, they've started the dragon. Equalizer's available. They can take this objective.
Dragon does go down, but what are they going to lose? If anything here, King are poised to try and fight. MLXG getting in. That's a three-man knockup. Now Sky trying to dive in, but Looper gets hooked back here. Flayed into the team as well, and Assassin going to dive back in with the Aussie. Looper uses his. Almost dead there as the safeguard's going to keep him just safe enough for now, and King gonna try and run in. They do have Hecarim ulti almost up there. Candy gets flash charmed and hooked there as well, and Assassin gets the next kill. Sky's gonna line it. MLXG is here as well, and he's gotten the kill into Rek'Sai, but now Graves in the backline ripping through people as well. That's, I think, a double, maybe a triple, and it's an ace. And Trinity Force Merc Tread's already done. Dade gonna come in onto Assassin as well. Looks to use his ulti, but doesn't quite pull the trigger, and Assassin actually gonna dive back in. Might even look for it. There's the ulti finally for Dade, but Lame trying to land something up. Assassin does not. Sonya's and actually goes down there to Dade. Love City low there as well. MLXG trying to fire the Prey Seeker in, but the Lamb actually does get the kill into Love City. Play away there. But Looper gets the next kill. Very weird exchange, but 2-for-1 in favor of M3. Passing it over here, and even MLXG looking for a dive.
MLXG understands he can take a few turret hits, play aggressively, and there's the death sentence.
Yeah, Condi gonna get caught up there as well. Does safeguard away. MLXG gonna ride in there as Lee Sin comes back in, but Graves gets the tower and the kill. Assassin dives back in onto Candy. Good damage, and he just goes off. Heal Force out as collateral damage. Would have killed the Corki otherwise, and can get a kill, and they keep pushing.
I mean, to take down Dade.
Yeah, Thresh is here as well. Dade's got so few options left here. Does actually put the hook there. Assassin does use his Sonya's this time, and MLXG, he'll take that kill. They're forced to get away. Good blocking actually using the Tibbers in front of the Thresh to try and block off the death sentences, but another inhibitor tower finally falls for King.
So their only real initiation comes from Love CD, and look, wonderful Annie play last game. We're seeing kind of the limits of the Annie pick now. Whenever the Tibbers is off and they don't manage to get a pick out of it, M3 can't force anything, spot it, but they're probably just going to spot a dead Baron if they don't react much faster.
Yeah, they do use it now as well. I don't know if they can do anything about it. Dade, you're going to get chunked down as well. Assassin getting very aggressive, but teleports coming in for both teams now as well. King actually do not finish the Baron. They're going to dive in there. It's really low. Condi steals it away, but Ari gets the first kill. There's the playback onto Lee Sin, and that's Hecarim going to get the next one. M3 got baited into it, but they do get the Baron. Now MLXG going to run in. Skylo's looking for it. A charm lands onto Dade. Onslaught of Shadows comes in on top of collateral damage, and MLXG collects the third kill. Candy running for his life, and Liam flash hooks, does find the Corki, Flay back there, and Liam, that's the last kill, 4-4-0 there for King.
Liam is by far the MVP. They need to remove as many Baron buffs as possible to stop any potential reset button coming through with that Baron pickup. Now it's only Looper, but they will pick up this inhibitor. They just want to ensure that they haven't given a lifeline back to M3.
This particular horse, Dragon, is going to go over here as it's just respawned to King. They pick it up. Oh, before we can even flick over to it almost. That's three dragons now for King.
Till what, 2-3 minutes ago? It's a very late Spectre's Cow. Hecarim is looking like a very, very deceptively strong champion against the Rumble as we start the fight.
Yeah, Condi actually goes in, kicks Woosh away, but can't quite finish it there. He will flash out there. Looper's going to dive into the backline, but so shield onto this Graves. He survives with ease now as Rek'Sai gets the next kill onto Annie. Dade diving in the back, but just gets killed. That's four kills already. A double kill there for Graves. Sky charges for it with the ulti, and King have finished the game.
They went for the emergency engage, but that's all it was, with such a big gold lead coming out to King. And in basically a complete mirror of the first game, One for one, 1 point each. Doesn't help either of them, but no big hole to come back from either.
Yeah, Charge Ian going to take out the Nexus turrets here. Superman is going to help out with the tanking, and King will claim victory here in the second game versus M3, and we will stay even here, still tied seventh of both these teams.